Can you accept that I did what I thought was right?
When you think Captain America, you think of a very specific brand of person. There's so many different lines, so many different avenues, so many realities that we have to live in every day to be a successful black man in our society. You know, you can't be the same person every room you walk in. It's a hard duality that you have to live in. And sometimes, specifically for somebody like Sam, you have to ask yourself the question if that's something you're willing to deal with. I mean, I think 2020 and COVID and nothing else have proven how difficult it is to be a black man in America. It's not a new understanding or experience for anybody black.
Hey,
it's not bothering me. You know who this is?
Oh, God. I'm so sorry, Mr. Wilson. I didn't recognize you without the cover.
With Sam picking up the shield, you know, such a representation of the country that we live in. You know, there's a lot of trepidation as far as how does a black man represent a country that does not represent him.
We knew the journey that Sam was going on was particularly rough one, just because of the fact that he is a black superhero, right? Well, Anthony's backstory is rooted in Louisiana. And we merged some of that so that it could become really, really personal. Then they start telling you what they've done with the characters, and from that, a whole life is born.
I told you to speak to him before I come to my problem, and yet, here you are.
In our defense, we're supposed to have this done way before you woke up.
Well, I don't come to the sky, and it's going to have a barrel all over us. We don't come down here about that girl with things you couldn't understand.
The Otto Barrow came in and gave an amazing performance as my sister, and really gave that character a backbone that kind of defined the entire history of what this character, Sam Wilson, really is from the soldier till now.
I said you were a pilot. I never said pilot.
You see how all of that became this man from where he was. I enjoy learning who Sam Wilson truly is.
What would be the point of all the pain and sacrifice? If I wasn't willing to stay with the fight.
Sam's search for identity is about his future, and Bucky's search for identity is about his past. And for Bucky, what we don't want to do is abandon 10 years of storytelling. It was really important that we tackle those 10 years of storytelling and allow Bucky to process the events of his life in a way that he hasn't had time to in the two-hour stories that he's been a part of in the past.
When we were making First Avenger, there are always ideas of what could happen one day if we were so lucky to make a sequel. But the truth is, you're trying to get that movie right the first time, and you're not sure where any of this is going to lead.
Sergeant Bonds, send a priest of Hydra.
We'd be lying to say we didn't talk about where Bucky could go, but we didn't know how far we could take him, and where he might have gotten. And when you're seeing Sebastian portray Winter Soldier, which to us was even an extra level, we knew there was something to explore there.
What did I do?
No.
Everything Hydra put inside me is still there.
The relationship between Bucky and Steve is so dramatic and so filled with pathos. If you think about it, the only person who had believed in Bucky in the MCU up to this point was Steve Rogers. And now Steve Rogers is gone. Bucky goes to order to report his personal.
Closest thing I've got left to a family. So I'm retired and I feel like I had nothing left.
What was challenging for me was the balance between introducing the characters in a new way and yet making you still be aware of where they come from. You know, I always think with these movies, every time I come back, I'm always like thinking, okay, what if a fan sits down and watches Captain America, First Avenger, Winter Soldier, Civil War, The Avengers, now this, like, are they going to be able to see that same character throughout and then see that character evolve in new ways, but still be the same character?
I'm no longer the Winter Soldier. I have a chance, Bucky Barnes, and you're part of my efforts to make amends.
How does this character now function in the world? What's his life going back to work on now? How is he meeting people? How is he interacting with coffee shops? Is he dating? Is he, like, thinking about another career?
Look, you've got to nurture friendships. I am the only person you have called all week. That is so sad.
series is now his first chance to deal with that, whether or not he really is a killer in his DNA, whether or not he can be a hero, right? Like, am I even cut out?
There's always going to be a darker side of this character, which I always loved, and is, to me, what made him more interesting and complex. And, you know, like life, I feel like that doesn't go away. It's still there in a way. He's just learning how to deal with it a little bit more. Bucky is very much trying to come to grips with the things that he has done that can't be undone. And Sam Colton becomes a big part of his journey towards figuring out who Bucky Barnes is outside of the Winter Soldier moniker.
Still holding my wife.
what the show needs to say. And he provides, you know, a genuine desire to be good, but that's not enough to be Cap.
We thought Wyatt was an interesting choice because a lot of his work beforehand, he's replaced the stoner slasher with the long hair and the beard, but what we found in reading him is there is an energy, there's an edge to him that neither Sam Wilson nor Bucky Barnes has, and we felt that was important so that John Walker stood apart from these two characters. And to some degree, John Walker is coming into the show with a chip on his shoulder to prove that he is worthy of this mantle.
Just because you carry that shield, it doesn't mean you're Captain America.
Look, I've done the work. I gravitate towards characters too. Need to make difficult decisions, and they have to be one thing while trying simultaneously to toe the line of the other.
You consistently make the right decisions in the heat of battle.
Yep.
Three badges. Excellent. Sure, I never figured you were here in my life.
I had no idea the character I was playing. I was just excited just to be a part of this Marvel thing, so I had no idea that I was actually going to be an integral character at all. They're like, well, actually, you're Lamar Hoskins. I was like, oh, dude, I know Lamar Hoskins, because I literally have the comic books. I have them. I have those editions and everything. You know, that famous one where the Captain America one, and the humans are on the cover. I have that. Right? So I was just totally psyched. I was like, I hope I get a suit, man. I hope it makes me a suit.
The costume puts you in like that superhero costume that sort of feels weird if you just do it on your own. A word of advice then, stay the hell out of my way.
There's a lot of similarities construction-wise with John Walker's costume and all the previous Captain America costumes. You know, I wanted to keep feeling and look. So we used a lot of the same print fabric and colors that we used before. I think we did tweak the red a little bit and made it a little brighter and patriotic than some of the previous costumes.
Definitely helped the attitude of the character, because it was just a little bit more arrogant than I think that I would have been if I hadn't had a little help.
It's really important, I think, that when setting up a world, you get into the characterization as quickly as possible. And they both explored the conundrum of being a soldier and how difficult it is to walk the lines of following orders as well as doing the right thing.
I killed him because I had to!
Don't have a good day.
Have a great day.
In the lobby.
First of all, there's a lot of vengeance, because I just killed my best friend.